Hi everybody, welcome to the Bangalore Lanes for our first Candlepin Challenge match. We started out with about 50 bowlers and we've narrowed that field down to 16 where they're bowling head-to-head matches. Winner moves on, loser goes home. And we've got the final three matches for you, two semifinal matches and the final match. And in the first match, Mike LaBrie, what do we have?
We have Jeff Golding versus Ian Gordon.
Okay, so that's your first match and that's going to be coming up right after this.
Micah's Pub has a great selection of liquor and beer on tap. So grab all your friends and come on down for a bite to eat. Whether you're meeting up with friends for a night out or coming to watch the game, Micah's Pub has it all. Micah's Pub, located inside Bangor Brewer Bowling Lanes, or check us out on Facebook at facebook.com/Micah's Pub.
Okay, welcome back to the Bangalore Lanes. My name's Chip Carson, alongside Mike LaBrie, who's actually the owner of the sponsor of this television show, Micah's Pub. Mike, who do we have in the first match?
We got Jeff Golden against Ian Gordon, and Jeff's going to lead us off right here.
Okay, good lead.
That's a good start. Maybe a little nerves got to him. A lot of pressure, a lot of people in the background watching.
Looks like we have Charles Mound the IV in the background somewhere.
Here we go. Yep.
Definitely off the head pin the first couple balls. We'll see if he can pick up a 10 here.
Now, you bowled a lot of TV shows, Chip. Were you ever nervous back in the day? Or?
I think, honestly, if you're not a little bit nervous, then
you're doing something wrong. Yeah.
Absolutely. Jeff Golding with a 10 in his first box.
Good way to come back after getting one pin on the first ball.
Got that right. Do we have any information on Jeff? Does he have any interests?
Well, we asked the bowlers to give us some information about themselves, to give us a little more to talk about. And here's an interesting fact about Jeff. He likes to go mudding in his five-ton truck.
Five-ton truck.
Five-ton truck.
You know what they say about guys with five-ton trucks?
I do. I'd have a six-ton truck then.
Okay, slides by. Leaves the 2-4 for the 10. And he slides by.
All right. Maybe he can sit down, get the nerves out, come back. Get back on the head pin, maybe get a couple marks.
Okay, who do we have here, Mike?
All right, we got Ian Gordon, 19 years old. He's only been bowling a couple years.
It looked it on that first ball.
Yes, it did. Maybe we have to put the bumpers out for Ian. There we go. Got a few pins down.
There we go. Okay, he's looking at the 1, 3, and the 10 for the 10.
All right. Much better 9 than we thought he was going to have for the box. He actually bowled a 170 in the qualifying round to get on the TV show.
Well, that's pretty good. 170 plus his handicap of, what's his handicap?
I know we'll have to go to Evan Riva on the stats and get back on that.
Tell you what, he'd probably have over a 200 string, so.
35 is the
35,
handicap.
So that would be 205. All right, looking at the 1-2 for the 10 box here. And he slides by for an 8 box.
Chip, it says that his high series for 3 is 334. And he had the 170 string, so.
Well, I don't think that they're going to count the first three strings of a match like this. That would be like a league match or something like
right.
that. But, if you took his first three strings of the qualifying, I'm sure that he probably would have had a lot more than what his high three says.
Yeah. All right, Jeff Golden's back up. Still off the head pin.
Jeff throws really hard. He's got probably one of the fastest balls that we've got at Bangor Lanes. Problem is you have to be accurate with it.
Oh, almost. I actually noticed that back even when I bowled a lot, that when I threw the ball harder, I was less accurate. So
sometimes
I'd try to
take
a little speed off of it, and I noticed I'd pick my pins a little better than that.
Right.
All right, 10 box for Jeff.
So you're busy with Micah's Pub right now. How's the season going?
It's been a good season.
Excellent.
We have a good crowd, loyal people, of course, all the league bowlers. We want to thank them for coming in numerous weeks and supporting not only the bowling center, but the pub.
Okay, 7-pin drop for Jeff. leaving the 2-4-5. And sliding by again.
Oh, he's a little frustrated with that. I think he thought he had it.
That's actually a really tough shot. You've got to hit that perfect for it to go. And not picking up his single pins on the end. For another 8 box.
All right. Ian's back up now. I think we need to see a mark here soon, Chip.
Yeah, this is brutal.
I don't know about the crowd, but I'm getting a little tired. I might have to have another Red Bull just to keep going here. There we go. 9-pin drop, bunch of wood. See if that gets out of the way. It does.
Okay, he's got a clear shot at it. See if he plays the wood or plays the pin.
Oh, he tried to think do both. He just missed which way he was going. I'm not sure. James Milan in the background.
I can see the shine off. See the shine off his head.
James, who did not make the TV show. We'll talk about that a little later.
All right, a 9 box for Ian.
There we go. Good head pin hit.
He's had two good pocket hits right there.
Tough, kind of tough break. That wood, bad angle on that, Chip, you think? A little bit?
That's when you just throw it and hope. And you do have to play the wood, though.
All right, good 10.
All right, what do we have for a score here?
All right, we got Ian Gordon leading Jeff Golden 71-58 after 4 boxes.
And keep in mind, that is with handicap. That is with their handicaps all added in.
Yeah.
All right, Jeff Golding now.
All right. I think Jeff's a little more relaxed now. He's got a few boxes under his belt. He's got his wife and his new baby in the background. I think he's going to do something big coming up. Like that, he throws a hammer ball.
Nice ball.
There we go. That's going to make him feel a lot better.
All right, he may salvage 50 at the half anyway. All right.
Pulled it a little bit. I think he got a little too excited, maybe thinking about a double.
You always think about those doubles. Those add up real quick. Oh, that was a better hit than that. Leaves the 5, 8, and 9 for the 10 box. All right, good 10 for
good
Jeff.
10. All right, Ian's back up. Let's see now, he's got a get a mark here to try to hang with Jeff.
Okay, takes out the 10 pin.
Well, Ian came in as the number one seed for the tournament. So we got to see if he can start bowling like the number one seed. Everyone, I bet you he's wishing he had another 170 coming up. Maybe if he can pull out this match, get to the final.
All right, third ball up. Good hit. And ends up with an 8 box. Well, you can schedule your birthday parties right here at Bangaboro Lane. So all you get to do is give us a call and give us a little pre-book. And parties here are pretty cheap. They're only $50 for an hour and a half, $65 for 2 hours. And then, of course, we've got the birthday party pizza special, 2 large 16-inch pizzas and 2 pitchers of soda for $25. So pretty much for less than 100 bucks, you can have your whole party right here, and we clean up the mess, Mike.
That's true. Having a daughter, I've been to many places for birthday parties, and a lot of them charge double or triple for the price. And I think what we do here is a great deal for families and kids. And like you said, they can come in and have fun, play the arcade, do some bowling. We clean up for them. All right, after 6, it's 86-85. We got Jeff coming back up now.
Do we have any stats on Jeff?
We got some. He's been bowling for 12 years, so he must have been bowling in the Junior League. And he's a parts salesman at Darling's Auto Mall. His high 3 is 374. And his high single's 175.
Whoa, 175, and he ended up with a 374.
Yeah.
Well, that's different.
And he beat the minister of money bowling, James Mile, in the number 4 seed to get on to the TV show, 132 to 103. So James just didn't have it, I guess, in him for that match.
Definitely sucked on that one, huh?
He probably had to get back to Jimmy's ice cream. There's a rush there. Can't leave Chris in charge too long there. Things go bad.
All right, Jeff's first ball here.
I see Mike Merritt in the background eating something. It must be the delicious pizza and wings from Micah's Pub. Put a cheap pop and shout out to the bar in there. Bob Osgood in the background getting ready for his next match.
Oh, a good offer. All right, leaves the 5-9 for his 10 bucks. See if he can pick some pins here.
Now, Chip, for all the people that know of Candlepin bowling but not a lot about it and are watching the show, what are the best bowlers in bowling in the sport average?
Well, a real good average is 120 plus these days. I mean, back in the day, 25, 30 years ago, 120 average wouldn't get you anywhere. But today, 120 plus average is considered a really good average.
Yeah, people that know of the other bowling, that you know, there's a lot of strikes thrown and a lot of big scores. But in this game, it honestly could frustrate you a little bit more, and it's tough. Oh, that's a great shot. Nice spare for Ian. There you go. That getting fired up a little bit. Heard it from the crowd a little bit, so that's good. Let's see if he can get a big load on it. Oh, a solid 8 load.
Great pocket hit, but he leaves the 5 and the 7.
He's going to be able to play that wood to the right at an angle. You think that'll cut over? Oh, no, we lost that in the gutter. Oh, great offer.
He almost made that.
Seems like he's throwing a little better ball now, too. A little more relaxed, I think.
All right, slides by for the 9 box.
All right, after 8 frames, Ian Gordon, 113, leading Jeff Golden at 104.
Jeff's definitely got to have a mark right here to set himself up for the 10th if he's going to have any chance at this match. Jeff likes to wipe his balls off.
He does.
He's using a
he
towel.
Likes
usually,
clean balls.
Usually he uses his shirt, but I think for TV he's just using his towel
might be,
there.
He might be using his shirt a little bit, but he likes to turn around when he does that. I don't think he doesn't want anyone to know. And I thought we had a naked baby in the background, but there is a diaper on the baby, so nothing to be alarmed about.
Jeff still off that head pin.
Fell over, it looked like there, but I'm not sure if we call fouls or lobs in this or not.
Did he have a couple drinks at Micah's Pub before he came bowling?
He might have. Usually he just likes to get his chicken fingers with about 6 sides.
And his pitcher of orange soda. All right, a must mark right here for Jeff Golding. He knows it.
See if he can at least get on the head pin. Oh, he's off the head pin. That's going to be a tough hit to get that to go. But
the 1, the 2, the 5, the 8, and the 9.
Got to hit the head pin. That's the name of the game. Get the head pin, usually good things happen. Ooh.
Well, this is a disaster.
Are we going to use the brutal word, Chip?
No, we haven't used it yet.
Out? No.
All right, an 8 for Jeff.
All right. Ian's just going to finish up his 9th and 10th box here. Oh,
I'll tell you, Ian's been on the pocket. He's been hitting the pocket basically the whole string, and that's where it gets you a win right there. Slides by there, though. Ian doesn't have much of a backswing. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
I did. Just kind of almost lofts it out there.
I see a lot of people, some of them actually have a huge backswing. They bring the ball way over the top of their head.
Oh, just like
down.
Jeff. Jeff's kind of like
yeah.
that.
But I guess whatever works, whatever makes you comfortable.
That's right.
It looks like Ian's going to be advancing to their final.
Yes. There's that head pin staring at us again,
yeah.
Mike.
It's the pin the closest to you, so you think it would be the easiest to hit.
Wish it was that easy.
I think it's almost teasing you, like, hey, I'm right here, hit me. And it's just tough to do sometimes.
Okay, so the final score, Ian with a 132 and Jeff with a 120 with their handicaps. And that concludes our first match. And Mike, who do we have for the second match coming up?
We have Bob Osgood versus Aaron Astell.
Okay, that should be a real good one, and we'll be back with that right after this.
Micah's Pub has a great selection of liquor and beer on tap. So grab all your friends and come on down for a bite to eat. Whether you're meeting up with friends for a night out or coming to watch the game, Micah's Pub has it all. Micah's Pub, located inside Bangor Brewer Bowling Lanes, or check us out on Facebook at facebook.com/Micah's Pub.
Okay, we're back for the second semi-final match of the day. Chip Carson here with Mike LeBrie. And who do we have for these two characters, Mike?
A character indeed. We have Bob Osgood up starting at the match. Bob came in the number 7 seed, and he beat the number 2 seed, Larry Matthews, to advance the TV round.
All right.
Oh, that was a good shot. Should have went for Bob. That would have been nice to start with a spare.
I can't get my eyes off his head. Look at that set of hair he's got down there.
It says his occupation is electronic service, but to me, he looks more like a mad scientist. He just has a look to him. I've known Bob a long time, so I guess it's okay that I say that. He's been bowling for 53 years. So Candlepin Bowling in the Bangor Lanes, definitely thank him for his loyalty.
Yeah, Bobby bowls at least 2 leagues a week, I believe. Oh, good offer there, almost cut it over. Staring at the 4-pin for the 10 box.
Bob's high single is actually a 202, which is very rare in Candlepin bowling to have an over 200 string. He threw that 4 years ago on lanes 1 and 2, which are the toughest lanes in the house, most people think.
Most people think that. I don't agree with that.
I think it's all in their head.
Yeah, that could be.
All right, now we have Aaron Astell up, the number 3 seed. He beat Charlie Dargan, the number 11 seed, 119 to 115 to advance the TV round.
Aaron's the best-dressed bowler at Bangor Lanes.
That is true.
Okay, Aaron's looking at the 1, 2,
oh, we have
the
official
the
Carl with him. Oh, I think he's making a move. I think Carl's going for it. Nice hustle, Carl. I'm not going to lie. I kind of like to see Carl slip and go down. That'd make some good TV.
He went down the lane about five years ago to pick up a pin, and he bounced up real quick, and his head smacked into one of the DJ lights, ended up having to go to the hospital with stitches. What a beauty he is, huh?
And he just graduated from the University of Maine, so that tells you something about the
hairdressing
education system.
Hairdressing school.
Hairdressing school. He is a sharp-looking guy.
Yes, he is.
He puts a lot of time and effort into his hair.
All right. Aaron slides by for an 8-box.
Oh, he's hearing it from the crowd. They're booing him. They're having a good time booing him, too. James Milan in the background booing the guy on TV when James could not make the show.
Isn't that something?
That is the James Milan we know. Okay, Aaron's high single is 192, and his high series is 464.
Yeah, Aaron's got some good credentials. He's a good bowler.
He's been bowling for 20 years in Ellsworth and 3 years in Bangor.
Came up from Ellsworth.
He works at the Jackson Lab. All right, after 2 boxes, Bob Osgood has a 46-31 lead over Aaron Astell.
Aaron, of course, has another ball coming, so that'll cut into the lead a little bit. All right, Bob, solid
great
in the pocket.
Great headpin hit.
All right.
That was right in the pocket, like you said.
Leaving the 5-9.
Oh, just a little off. I think he knew when he released that it was a little to the right.
All right, sliding by again. So a 9-box for Bob Osgood. Sliding over to the other lane. See what we got going here, Bob.
Like I said, Bob's been a loyal league bowler for years. Chip, you want to tell people watching about our league program?
Yeah, the league program starts in September, right after the Labor Day holiday. And it lasts for 32 weeks, and it's a lot of fun. The people that have bowled in the leagues, it's not like it used to be, Mike, when there was, you know, a waiting list, but it's still a real good time. It gets rid of the wintertime blues.
It gives people a reason to come out one night a week. Some of them bowl multiple leagues for a couple hours. Have some fun, meet some new people, bowl with some old friends. And the good thing about the Candlepin bowling is anyone can do it.
Yes, anyone can do it. That's a good point. All right, up now again, Aaron Astell. Heard Aaron bounce that ball a little bit.
I think he did. I'm surprised Carl didn't say anything. Carl's watching him like a hawk, though. What?
Well, you can hear Carl from a mile away. He's got that real deep voice.
Knowing Carl well, I know one of his dreams is actually to be a commentator in some form on a program in the future, maybe a bowling show. So hopefully that'll work out
maybe
for Carl.
Maybe we can sneak him in as a guest host.
Yeah,
right?
Give him a shot.
8 bucks for Aaron Astell.
I'd like to take a minute also to congratulate you, Chip, for winning the state championship.
No, you brought that up.
That's right, your seventh title.
Seven state titles. I never thought I'd win one at my age now, but...
How many years was it between the seventh and the sixth and the seventh?
Oh, it's been a good 15 years.
15 years.
Yeah.
Well, congratulations to you.
I appreciate that, Mike.
And you bowled a really good score to win.
Well, good for today. Compared to 15, 20 years ago, but 12:33 today at the Big 20 in Scarborough, that's not bad.
You still knocked enough pins down to win.
That's all that
counts. All right, after four boxes, Bob Osgood's got a 65-53 lead over Aaron Astell.
And again, that's with all the handicap included. So now it's just a box per box match right now. Just off the head pin. And he's going to be leaving the 1, the 2, the 4, and the 10 for the spare with some wood that may or may not be his friend in the back. We'll have to wait and see.
Oh, right on it. Great shot.
Okay, let's see what he can get for a load here. Trying to keep that right in the pocket, Bob.
Actually, he caught a better break than the pin that he hit.
He sure did.
Six pin drop, six load on the spare. See if he can pick this up.
Yeah, just slides by the head pin. Tell you, picking your pins on the third ball, that is the main thing. And a lot of people don't realize that. They kind of get up the third ball and kind of chuck it away or just don't concentrate as much. A lot of pins can be added at the end of the string if you pick your pins.
It's one of the things I used to always do when I bowled. I was never a big strike bowler, but I picked my pins. I got nines and tens, spares. It matters when you're in a match, even in a league. If you're a few pins here and there, you notice people don't put the effort in or they just don't. They're not as accurate.
And then all of a sudden you're losing by a pin or two.
That's right. Those pins add up.
Okay, Aaron way off the head pin on that one.
Whoa. Put a little extra heat on that one, I think, too, and pulled it.
That was brutal. All right, let's see if he can at least make some kind of a ball out of this. He is dropping the ball, which usually Aaron's pretty smooth on the line.
There we go. Good 10. Good 10 box to get out of that. One thing you don't want to get a 5 or 6 box on TV.
Anywhere. Anywhere. Whether it's TV or not, but I'll tell you what, that adds some pressure on you. You have to have a mark 5 just to get back to the even mark. Still off the head pin. But he's got a pretty good break there. If he can hit the pocket, that should go pretty quick.
He's got a lot of wood on the plate to work with. And there you go, just like that.
Great
spare shot. All right. After 6, Bob Osgood 91-73, but Aaron has a ball working on a spare in the 6. Let's see what Bob can do right now.
All right, Bob off the head pin, leaving the 1, the 3, the 7, and the 8.
Right on it.
Oh,
there, what a great shot.
That was a great shot.
Yeah, a little fist pump from Bob, getting fired up a little bit. Now
Bobby.
We're going to hear from the crowd a little bit in the background. Standing room only tonight at the Bangaboo Lanes for the Maine Candlepin Challenge.
I think I heard Kyle. All right.
Let's see what he gets for a load on there. A little off the head pin. Not a bad load for being off the head pin.
1, 3, 5, 8, 9, 10. Got to go after this just by looking like punching it right out. Yeah. A little too thin. Just takes out the head pin. Work to do to get a box out of this, and he does. That's a good 9 box out of that.
That's a good out for Bob. All right, let's see what Aaron can do.
His first ball is going to be big. All right, right.
Oh.
Right there.
Great pocket hit, 9-pin drop, bunch of wood to work with, but that wood in the front there could be a little trouble if he hits it at the wrong spot.
I think he's got it covered, but not on the cap.
He capped it.
That was about the only place
that would
have gone.
The infamous cap, you never cap.
He only had about 2 feet to work with. Oh, well.
He might have thought that was a guaranteed spare after that 9-pin drop of all that wood, but that is candlepin bowling, people.
All right, so a 10 box. Gonna shake that one off and just concentrate on the next one. That one's history.
A little full on the head pin, I think.
Yeah, leaves the 2, 4, 7, and 10. Gonna make a pretty good cut shot to make this.
Well, you knew that right when you released it.
Yeah, that was ugly.
I'd also like to take a quick second for thanking Mother Nature for working out with us tonight and so we could tape the show. Buckets of fun at the Bangor Lanes, right, Chip?
The only bowling alley in the state that prays for sun.
All right, Bob's back up in the 9th frame, up 13 pins. Let's see what he can do here. He's got a good lead, but that could vanish in a good head pin hit.
Okay, Bob leaves the 2, the 4, the 5, the 7, and the 8 with a bunch of wood in the middle. Stay on that front pin, and it should carry.
That wood on the plate should give him some help. And just like that, he gets a great spare shot. Again, he's on the object pin.
Okay, spare in the 9th. Good setup for the 10th box here.
He's putting a little extra pressure on Aaron, too. Aaron's going to have to mark big time to catch up with him.
Exactly.
A little off the head pin. Four load on the spare. That adds to the lead unless Aaron can mark in the 9th. Ooh. Now he wants to make sure he gets just a few pins at least out of this.
Yep, make it a box. Either way, it's going to force Aaron to throw a couple marks.
Oh,
at the
good
end.
10.
Excellent.
That's a clutch 10 there. Finish it out. For 138 total for Bob. Now Aaron's got some work to do.
Okay, Aaron needs 37 pins here in the last 2 boxes to tie. Let's see what he can do.
That was the hammer ball right there. That should have went for him.
Okay, leaves the 6 pin. Must mark for Aaron.
We're talking about picking your pins. Let's see if he can stay on it right here. No wood to help. Oh, that's a clutch shot right there. Nice spare. Keeps him in the match.
Still got to have another mark.
Some of the crowd in the behind jawing at him a little bit. He's having a good time of that. Bob is sitting patiently. Doesn't want to look. Let's see what happens here. Another great head pin hit. Another 9-pin drop for Aaron.
Wow, that could have easily been a double strike in the 9th and the 10th box for Aaron. I bet he's
got a good amount of wood here to work with.
It's one of those shots where if you miss it, miss left.
But he missed the 9-pin drop earlier with wood, but he does not here. Clutch spare in the 10th frame.
Okay, looks like 8 to tie and 9 to win. So coming right down to the last ball here in the second semi-final match of the Candlepin Challenge.
That's firing up the crowd too, which we like to see and hear.
Ooh.
Off the head pin. Let's see. Oh, it's going to. Oh.
He caught a break on that, missed the head pin, and ends up with an 8 to tie the match.
138 to 138.
Okay, on the overtime rules, it's a two-box roll-off, and they get one-fifth of their total handicap added to the score. So Bob Osgood is going to get 5 pins, and Aaron Astle will get 2 pins. So up first, Bob Osgood.
All right, a little bonus bowling here, Chip. 143 to 140. Bob's got the 3-pin lead going to the two bonus boxes.
Okay, off the head pin a little bit, but getting some good backdoor action
there. Nice 8-pin drop there for being off the head pin. Bob, you know, Bob's been pretty good on his object pins. Let's see if he can hit the head pin, pick this up. And there he does. Great
All
spare
right.
shot for Bob. Another
fist pump
there. He's fired up. We like to see that side of Bob.
Bob likes to win. He's always been a competitor. The leagues, I'm telling you, he is a tough bowler in the leagues.
Yeah, his team used to beat my team a lot back in the day. We didn't know how he did it, but he did it.
Ouch. All right. A little bit of a choke ball there, Bobby. Come on now.
Maybe his hair got in his eyes.
All right, second ball up.
Oh, back on the head pin. That's good.
Maybe. Oh, just didn't fall the right way.
He almost pulled that out.
Sure
did. Let's see if he can get the 10.
Either way, it's going to force Aaron to get at least one mark.
I think he's staring at the pin like he cannot believe that it didn't fall down.
Playing the dead wood.
He tried to play the dead wood. He tried to get cute with that.
Ends up with a 9 box.
He's hearing it a little bit from the crowd.
All right, so he has a total with the first 10 boxes and the next two of a 164. So Aaron has got to have a mark in one of these two boxes.
Not only a mark, but a mark with a solid load. He doesn't want to get a mark with a good load and then end up getting a 7-8 box in the 10th.
And once again, off the head pin and that same break, the 1-3 for the spare.
Oh, that's the shot that Bob just had. Let's see if Aaron can also hit the head pin and pick up the spare so he doesn't have to think that he needs a mark in the last box. And just like that, oh, he cut that over a little bit, came back off the wall, picks up the spare. These guys are immune to the pressure of being on TV for the first time and bonus bowling. Got to give him credit for that.
Well, this is a big ball. This is basically it for Aaron. He throws a good load and probably has it in the bag. Good pocket.
A solid
hit.
Head pin hit there and 6 load.
Okay, he needs 2 pins.
2 pins out of the.
2 pins to tie, 3 to win.
Yeah.
Oh, nice shot. Picks
Great
up
shot
the spare.
For Aaron's. Picks up the spare. And that about does it, Chip.
It does. 166, 164 win, but he does have this last ball just for numbers. And Aaron is going to advance to the finals. Oh, okay. 1 load. Glad he didn't need more than that. We'll be back with the finals right after this.
Micah's Pub has a great selection of liquor and beer on tap. So grab all your friends and come on down for a bite to eat. Whether you're meeting up with friends for a night out or coming to watch the game, Micah's Pub has it all. Micah's Pub, located inside Bangor Brewer Bowling Lanes, or check us out on Facebook at facebook.com/Micah's Pub.
Okay, welcome back to the Bangor Brewer Lanes for the final match of this first Candlepin Challenge. The winner is going to be receiving a $500 check and the loser a $300 check. Mike, what do we have?
We have the number 3 seed, Aaron Astle, against the number 1 seed, Ian Gordon, in the championship match. Aaron's going to lead us off. And now that we have a second, we would like to thank everybody for bowling in this tournament and for the first time for the TV show. We're excited about the turnout, and we're looking forward to the next show that will be in September. Anyone wants to come bowl, please call 989-3798 or stop in the bowling center and talk to Chip, Evan, or myself. We'd love to have you. We'd love to have a big crowd for the next TV taping. And I think it's exciting that we have a bunch of new bowlers and some new blood in the sport. What do you think, Chip?
Well, the game does need some new bowlers. Always loving the new bowlers. Aaron with a punch on that one for a 9.
Fox.
We'll let that go.
Yeah, we're going to let that go.
All right.
All right, so how many pins is Ian up with the handicap chip?
Okay, Aaron's going to be facing a 22-pin deficit right off the bat.
Okay.
So he's got to pick up 22 pins and 10 boxes.
Do you think he's thinking about that, or do you think Aaron's just trying to bowl a big score?
You know, I'm not really sure. Of course, it's in the back of your mind, but you just want to get out there and throw 10 good boxes. Stay in the pocket, and you never know what your opponent's going to throw, so just you got to pay attention to your own game. Nice shot there by Aaron.
That is a great spare shot for Aaron, so he's going to sit down after two on a mark. And we got Ian up. Like you said, he's up to 22 going to the match. Let's see if he can at least put a 10 or a mark together to stay with that pin lead on Aaron.
Great pocket hit right there. Just leaves the 5 pin for the spare.
I hope he doesn't play with the wood. You got to go right to the 5 pin. Oh, he went for the wood, actually. He did not listen to me.
Now we know how to play the shot.
Maybe that's why he's on TV and I'm commentating and I don't bowl anymore.
Okay, see what he can get for a load here. I'm sure Ian's just thinking, hey, I just want to stay with
the
pitch out.
7. He likes that 7 pin. Unfortunately, he's on a mark, so that's not going to help. But it is, I guess, one extra pin to pad on his lead. But Aaron's got a mark in the second frame, so he's got some pins coming up for him right now. So let's see if he can get at least a couple pins here to get an 8 box. You don't want to go down a 6-7, so a 7 after the second frame gives him a 21-pin lead. 53-32, Ian leads Aaron after 2, but Aaron is on a mark.
Aaron sinking pocket hit right here. Got a little spin on that ball every time.
Yeah, Carl's watching him like a hawk behind.
I'm sure. All right. Off the head pin.
Off the head pin, but a great 8-pin drop with some wood to work with.
Okay, leaves the 4-7 for the spare. Definitely going to be hitting the wood on this. The only place this isn't going to go is the cap.
There you go.
Picks it up.
Picks up the spare. It's 2 in a row for Aaron. Got to chip into that lead for Ian any way he can. Couple marks back to back. Good loads. That'll do it. It's nice to see Bob and Jeff in the background.
After, yeah, it's pretty good. They hang around
after
they lose.
That's good sportsmanship watching the championship match.
Would also like to thank Charles Milan III, of course, the founder of this great bowling center. He stayed in Florida all season, so we'd like to thank him for that.
Yes, thank you, Charlie. We miss you, and we might not see you until, what, Christmas?
All right, another spare up for Aaron Askell.
That's 3 in a row for Aaron.
Hey, I wonder if these guys thought of bonus money. I don't think they're awarding any kind of bonus money.
We got to do something about that. Maybe Micah's Pub can throw some money in for the next show for some bonus money for the 3 marks in a row.
We've got that on tape right there.
I know. I said it. So in order for us to get some bonus money at Micah's Pub, you're going to have to come in and sample some of our delicious food, our buffalo chicken pizza, our boneless wings.
Boneless wings. I got to tell you something, Mike. Those will compare to anybody's in town. They're awesome.
Great
they
shot by Ian.
Awesome. Okay, see if Ian can start out with a mark here.
Oh, he's on that 7 pin again. He likes that 7 pin.
Disgusting. I hate when that happens.
Now I think he's going to try to overcompensate. He might miss right. Oh, no. That's what he did earlier. He almost picks up the spare with that.
Domino effect action. He's got the 8 pin for the 10. Keep it on the lane. There you go.
All right, that's a good 10 box. All right, after 4, Ian is leading Aaron 73-69, but Aaron's working on a spare after he's had 3 in a row. So he's quickly got into that 22 pin lead from Ian. He's chopped away pretty quick after that.
Well, that's good. Why wait till the end? Get him now.
Ouch. Oh, that was a nonchalant fist pump that I think Bob could have taught him how to do much better, but he's still working on the 3 marks with a 2, so could have been a lot worse. Oh, back on the head pin.
Okay. He's going to try to get a couple pins right here to get a nine box. All right, and he does. All right, close match going on right now. Okay, working in the six box, Aaron Astle. Off that head pin, leaving the four horsemen left. The one, the two, the four, and the seven. Not an easy shot.
You don't want to hit the head pin too full on this because it's going to chop back.
That's right. Sometimes you can hit this thing what you think is perfect and leave that corner pin.
Nope, he knew it right when he released it that he missed it left. But again, if he could pick his pins and get a 10 out of this, those 10s add up.
Sure do.
Nope.
Blows right by the head pin for a 9 box. And back up is Ian. In the corner again, from one extreme to the other. He's got the corners all set out. Now let's see if he can get solid in the pocket.
I think he has to slow everything down just like that.
Actually, that was a great pocket hit. But unfortunately, it leaves the four pin. Okay, and another nine box.
All right, let's see if Ian can get on the head pin on his first ball, because that's what you want to do. You want to get that first ball on the head pin. Get yourself a good spare opportunity, hopefully a strike.
After six frames, it is dead even.
Oh,
and another seven pin.
He likes that seven pin. Back on the head pin, though. At least I'll say this, that he can get back on the head pin after missing left to right. See if you can pick the two out for the nine. Like we said, every pin, you want to get every pin you can. You don't want to leave pins on the plate just like that.
Especially in a one-string match.
All right, after six, we are dead even, 89 to 89. Four boxes left. So those three marks that Aaron put together eliminated that 22-pin advantage by Ian with four boxes to go. But Ian still has plenty of time to gather himself and get on the head pin and get maybe a mark or two. Try to eliminate Aaron.
Great pocket hit right there for Aaron. Leaving the 4-7-8 spare shot.
Oh, you hear it from the crowd a little bit as he released it. Missed a little left.
Yeah, that was a little cheese right there.
Yeah,
I think.
And he's laughing it off. Yeah. Like
well,
you said,
naturally.
Great personality. It is what it is, and just throw the next ball. Plenty of boxes left, and now the crowd's still giving it to him. I don't know what's going on, but Ian's having a good time with it.
Ian might have paid him off.
Yeah. Some of the money he earned at Frank's Bakery, which we'd like to thank Frank's Bakery for bowling in the leagues yet another season. Guest scorekeeper Evan Riva had a good time with that, too. You can see him laughing in the background. Back to the action. Aaron off to the head pin. That's a tough break there.
That is a real odd break, too. Yeah. The one, the three, the five, six, eight. You don't see that very often.
Ooh. He was right on it, but he just chopped a little bit.
People don't realize there's 12 inches between those pins, and that can happen. And an eight box.
All right. All right, Ian's up, going in. Well, off the head pin again, but he gets a great break. A lot of pins wobbling here, but none of them are going down. He's got a seven pin drop with some wood, but he got to be careful on that head pin. You don't want to miss left and cap it. Oh, he hit that perfect. It just didn't go for him. Oh, maybe I spoke too soon. No, all right. That's all he could do there is hit that head pin.
All right,
good 10 for Ian.
All right. So he is up one pin after seven boxes. So let's go right down to the wire here.
Well, again, off the head pin, but another good break considering, oh, we got a pin out on the lane. We're going to see if Carl's going to have to retrieve that. Nope, it's in the gutter. Keep the action going.
Nope. Oh, slides by the head pin again. Looking at the 1-3 for the 10. Can't stress enough, pins are important right now.
Nope. All right.
So a 9 box.
After 8. Ian is leading Aaron by 2 pins, 108 to 106.
Aaron's usually a good pressure bowler. Let's see if he can do the same right now.
And he's setting the pace here, so he's going to see what he can get, and then Ian's going to have to follow it, which could be more pressure on Ian. Ooh, he's got the 1-7-10, but a little bit of wood here, Chip.
Yep.
Does that wood matter? You just want to try to hit the head pin?
Yeah, you just
want to
aim for the head pin. I mean, you can't trust that wood. It looks pretty good, but you never know. Nice shot.
Oh, what a clutch spare shot for Aaron. The 1-7-10 is usually not the shot that goes, even when you hit it, but for him to hit that in the ninth frame in tie match.
Key ball right here. Ouch.
A little off the head pin.
Okay, the 1-3-4-7-9 for the spare. Make sure of a good count for the box and force Ian to have at least one good mark.
Oh, good ball for Aaron on the head pin. He's trying to guarantee to get a few pins off the plate. You don't want to get a 5-6 box after getting a load on a spare.
All right, 9. What do you have there? 8 box to finish up with. So it forces Ian to have a mark. See if he can do it. Just a little bit of pressure on this guy that only bowls
bowling
one
2 years.
A week.
Still, it cracks me up. The 2 years he's been bowling. He's on TV and he's bowling really well, actually. Like I said, 170 to get on the TV show. Oh, he almost comes back. A little backdoor spare opportunity. Got him smiling at least. Maybe he can pick it up to 10, and then we're up to the 10th frame. It all comes down to this. Ian needs a mark in this frame to win. If not, then Aaron will be our first champion. Want to make sure he takes his time. He looked like he rushed that out. He's on the head pin, though, with a 6-pin drop. He's got a potential spare opportunity here.
That's a tough break leaving the bucket right there. Just off, just an eighth of an inch, and that's the difference from having a real
break.
Oh,
well, yeah, he's kind of eyeing the pins there. I just don't want to think he released the bad timing on the release. And that's basically going to do it. Aaron Assel is going to be our first champion on the Candlepin Challenge, sponsored by Micah's Pub at the Bangalore Bowling Lanes. But you have to give Ian a lot of credit for his first time.
Yes, final score, Aaron Astle 129, Ian Gordon 124. And that's going to wrap it up for now, and we'll be back with the final right after this.
Micah's Pub has a great selection of liquor and beer on tap. So grab all your friends and come on down for a bite to eat. Whether you're meeting up with friends for a night out or coming to watch the game, Micah's Pub has it all. Micah's Pub, located inside Bangor Brewer Bowling Lanes, or check us out on Facebook at facebook.com/Micah's Pub.
Okay, welcome back to the Bangor Brewer Lanes, and there you have your winner, 129-124 win for Aaron Astle, $500 in his pocket. I'm sure he's liking that, and that takes us to the conclusion. Mike, you got anything to say?
Just congratulations to Aaron, and we hope to see everybody in September for the next TV taping, and thank you to everyone for all the bowling, and we had a good time, Chip.
We had a great time, Mike, and
hope
like
to see
I said,
everybody in September.
It was a great turnout for the first one. Basically, it was just word of mouth, and hopefully now that this is going to be on YouTube, hopefully we'll double the amount of people, which will mean double the amount of prize money.
And we need to double the amount of crowd in the background. And let's everyone come out, have a good time, make some noise, and enjoy some bowling action.
That'd be great. Okay, wrapping it up here at the Bangor Lanes, Chip Carson, Mike Labrie. We'll see you next time.